Blackstone presents The Infiltration Game by Brian Andrews. This book is read by MacLeod Andrews. For my daughters, with unconditional love. A note from the author. In the course of researching this novel, I struggled to discern truth from fiction, news from propaganda, and legitimate business deals from espionage cloaked in capitalism. Instead of trying to simplify, deconflict, or selectively pare back a tangled web of findings, the web became the novel. At its heart, The Infiltration Game is a study of the complexities of modern espionage and influence. And yet, it's also so much more. It is a story of two nations, two fathers, and two daughters, and how the yin and yang of nationalism, fidelity, and love can either rip us apart or bring us together. Prologue. Four Seasons Hotel, Washington, D.C., Monday, 27th of August, 2122 hours. She did not consider herself a prostitute, nor a murderer. She was a hunter of men, a lioness, whose soul was mistakenly birthed in a human vessel. She inspected herself in the bathroom mirror. Platinum blonde hair framed her high chiseled cheekbones and angular jaw. She tugged on the wig, testing the layers and layers of bobby pins she had painstakingly inserted several hours earlier. After groping her, men always tried to run their fingers through her long faux locks. Tonight's wig seemed to invite this behavior more than any other in her wardrobe. Satisfied that it was secure, she opened her purse and found a tube of hooker red lipstick. She applied it quickly and expertly to her parted lips. Like the rest of her body, her lips were thin and hard. Lipstick, when liberally applied, helped create the illusion that they were plump and juicy. She blew herself a kiss in the gold-framed mirror and dropped the lipstick back into her purse. She tugged upward on her strapless red and black satin corset, replete with push-up padding, until her bust line was bulging.
"What's taking so long?"
the job called from the bedroom.
"I don't have all night, sugar. We're both on borrowed time here."
She pursed her lips in annoyance. Politicians, CEOs, military officers, they were all the same. Always in a rush, always pretentious, and always wholly unprepared for whatever punishment she was primed to inflict. On the rare occasion that a job was someone she deemed worthy, she would incorporate real sex into the hunt. It amplified the thrill and the regret tenfold. But she would not let this man inside her. Such a privilege had to be earned. Regardless of the mission objective, that decision would always be hers and hers alone to make. She had never given herself to a lover. If a champion wanted her flower, he had to possess the mettle to take it. Few had been given the opportunity, and even fewer had succeeded.
"Now, Mr. Chapman, y'all flew me all the way from Dallas for this rendezvous. Surely you can give a girl 5 minutes to primp before you ravage her?"
she replied with a Texas drawl, one she had been practicing for the past several days. She heard him mumble something in protest, but she ignored him and retrieved a glass jar of clear liquid. She unscrewed the cap and dipped her left index finger up to the second knuckle in the material. After withdrawing her finger, she watched the liquid cure into a thin, transparent film on top of her skin. She fanned it completely dry and then used a lighted magnifying makeup mirror to inspect the coating on her finger. Satisfied, she screwed the cap tight on the jar and tossed it into her purse. Next, she retrieved a sealed square foil pouch, like the kind used to store single-use alcohol swabs. She tore the end open and gingerly extracted a sheet of paraffin-coated paper that measured 1 inch square. The white paper was devoid of any logos, labels, or instructions, and simply marked 20 milligrams, C34H47NO11, in gel suspension. With tweezers, she removed a translucent, sticky, gelatinous orb from the paper and stuck it firmly to the tip of her coated left index finger. Using the tweezers, she dropped the paper.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.